election posters, the Chancellor is calling for a new consensus. But with whom, the Free Democrats are asking. Given their gains in the three state elections, the FDP feel ready to become part of a federal coalition.
We must prevent a left-wing government, a left alliance, a left majority. That's why it would be good and helpful for the CDU to stop keeping all its options open and make a clear statement that we want a center-right coalition of Christian Democrats and the FDP.
The CDU-CSU does want that in principle, but the Chancellor is not ruling out other options. She's not calling for a coalition with the Free Democrats against the SPD. Her strategy in times of crisis is not to polarize. She's presenting herself as the Chancellor of the middle ground.
I refuse to think in terms of camps. I'll be talking to people, and for that reason I will not be getting more aggressive. Instead, I'll put forward my arguments. And I don't have the impression that being louder and more forceful in the way you talk has any effect on how it convinces the voters.
Merkel is far ahead of her challenger, her current deputy and foreign minister, Frank-Walter Steinmeier of the SPD. Even though the Social Democrats lost votes in the states, Steinmeier is now seeing his chance. He's setting himself up in contrast to the Chancellor as the candidate of social justice, opening up a fierce election campaign.
Anyone who says we can just keep going the way we are in this crisis is knocking our society off balance. And that's why the Conservatives and the Free Democrats cannot be allowed to govern after September 27th.
Social justice is the new focus of the campaign, which had centered on the financial crisis.
Everything is about economic competence, about knowing how such a crisis can be tackled. And the Conservatives have had an advantage there, together with the FDP. The pendulum may now be swinging back in the direction of social competence.
The Greens are also benefiting from that. Their gains have given them some confidence in the battle for the Bundestag.
We want to stop a CDU-FDP coalition and prevent another grand coalition between the CDU and the SPD. Green is a party that stands for a change of policy. We won't let Merkel continue to get away with not talking about the issues.
The left party's campaign is sticking to the basics, and that has gone down well in Thüringen, Saxony and Saarland. For the first time, the left party, under its leader, Oskar Lafontaine, took more than 20% of the vote in a Western German state election. That makes the left party a force to be reckoned with.
The left party is one of the winners of the day. The CDU and FDP have been shown their limitations. The SPD is happy when its losses are not too big here and there, and when it has a chance because of us. And these votes have certainly shown that the federal election is still anybody's race.
The Social Democrats are worried they will lose votes to the left party. And the voters?
I still trust the SPD.
I wish the left party could win. I have to say, Ms. Merkel doesn't hide things, and she doesn't try to make them look better than they are. My impression is she's honest.
I'm a bit bothered by it all at the moment, because the left party that I really didn't support is starting to sound pretty good. But right now they're all saying the same things.
The parties all have a lot to do in the 3 weeks until the election. Otherwise, voters might not turn out.
What we generally see when elections are concerned is that voters go to the polls when important issues are at stake and they believe their vote counts. That's when turnout goes up.
And that's when we'll find out who will be forming a coalition with whom, making up the next Bundestag.